tell me your...
My name is Brenda Gale. I've come home to relax after an exciting investigation in England.
Welcome home, Miss Gale. Don't forget your luggage.
Brenda, I'm so glad you picked up. Liza's gone missing. You've got to find her. She was excited about going to this camp, so we sent her. We wanted to support her. We went to visit her today, but when we got there, all we found was an abandoned town. Liza and the rest of the kids are missing. Please, Brenda, find Liza. I don't want to take the baby there if it's dangerous. I'll join you once the sitter arrives. Here's the address.
I've searched this place thoroughly, but haven't found any sign of those kids. The local papers say there have been reports of strange lights and children's voices. Some townspeople have seen a woman emerging from the mines. The camp rep is behaving strangely, too. You're a parapsychologist, aren't you? Why don't you try talking to her? Her name's Molly. Step aside, ma'am. This is a job for law enforcement. Gosh damn raccoons. Always causing trouble.
This must belong to one of the missing kids.
Children. They're mine now.
What happened?
She seems to be out of her mind. I hope she'll be able to give answers for our questions later. Ms. Gale, there's a town map in my briefcase. You may examine it. I'll stay here with Molly and wait for backup. You go on ahead and I'll join you once they arrive.
I was out exploring one day when I found a gorgeous antique bracelet. I haven't been myself since I put it on. I must find their descendants and take revenge. Easy to get to kids when you're their camp counselor.
I'm having trouble reaching anyone. I know one of the missing kids is your niece, so I won't bother trying to keep you here any longer. Take the map. I'll catch up as soon as I track down some help.
Gem of Fury hands out its own justice.
Innocent souls, their bodies gone. Four wandering souls will find their home. You can find me in my favorite hiding place. Home sweet home is what I know, but my treehouse is all my own.
Officer, do you read? This is Brenda Gale. I spotted one of the kids, but lost him. There's something fishy going on here.
You're not kidding. Listen, we tried to get you some backup by chopper, but some strange water spout or whatnot rose up and blocked the way. As if something's trying to keep us away. I called for more help. Hang on out there.
Whoever comes to us lives with us. Miss Teacher's gone insane. Whoever comes.
comes whatever's done will always be to
We shall have our revenge!
Thank you.
Sullivan, where are you?
I'll find you.
Thank you. One day, a fortune hunter by the name of Wolf Adams discovered an old map leading to a cave full of gems. It was rumored that anyone who entered the cave after midnight would be dead by sunrise. But Wolf disregarded the rumors as silly superstitions. Using the map, he found the cave and was bedazzled by the iridescent gems. Wolf claimed the gems for himself and vowed that he wouldn't leave until he had them all.
me hide from her. She's getting ready for the ritual. I'm so tired of being someone else. Listen, you've got to find Rebecca. Finally, I can hide from her. Go find the rest.
Look for me in my favorite hiding place. My shrine to science is in the corner. I hid the books and never bother. Our teacher's wise. Our teacher's great. She taught us well to face our fate.
In the 1930s, archaeologists found a rare gem ore in the mountains of Arkansas. A local landowner named Wolf bought the entire area out from under the expedition. The state was not aware of the treasure that lay just under the ground. Wolf founded a small town near the gem deposit. He filled the town with miners and appointed his old friend, Lewis Abbott, as mayor.
Mr. Mayor, I'm paying you to take care of things, not tolerate a public outcry. These rabble-rousers need to be dealt with. I won't shut down this mine if the devil himself takes a minor...
You're probably right. I'll figure out how to calm everyone down. Continue mining as you have. But remember, my cooperation doesn't come cheap. That meddling teacher is protesting.
Deal with her yourself.
Rebecca. Didn't expect to see me, did you? Stop running and just give up already.
Hey, over here! Come and get me. She's got the kids. You have to save them. If she gets us all, she'll be able to do the ritual.
Where are you, Rebecca? Show yourself. You can't hide from me.
Wolf built a town near the cave for the people working in the cave. Soon the town was filled with workers and their families. Wolf tried to keep the legend about the cave from the people. He also paid the townspeople in the hopes that they wouldn't ask questions. Wolf made one of his men, Nicholas, the town's mayor.
Rebecca. I knew you'd be at the school. You're my best student. Come here. I'll catch you.
Thank you.
with you makes me happy. Your friendship's kind and true. Your smile takes my fear away. I'm glad when I'm around you. Everybody wants to know how far she's gonna go. Who was he? You'll have to wait and see. She used to be really nice. After the accident, all she wanted was revenge. Please, save us. We don't want to take over those kids' bodies. We just want to be free. Please, hide me from her. Oh, thank you. There are two more of us hiding. You should find them.
Hiding in my favorite place. Cast a bait, fill the plate, cast a net, dinner is set.
I don't want her to find me. I'm scared. My Oregon my grandpa gave me long ago, and I'll let my happiness show. from her. Thank you. Now I just need to find Linda.
When all of the gems were gathered from the cave, they'd reappear at night. Wolf had a few younger workers working at night. He made sure to pay them in large sums before their shifts. Then the people working night shifts started dying of cardiac arrest at dawn. Wolf's guards removed the bodies at sunrise and took the money they'd been given.
Find me in my favorite hiding place.
Push my swing, oh, this I sing.
Ticket, please.
A young teacher came to town. One day, she found an old music box near the cave. It held a bracelet and information about a curse on the gems. When she tried to tell others, they ignored her. The teacher showed the manuscript to others. The people she showed wrote a threatening note and put it into her purse. They stole the manuscript and burned it. When she went to show the mayor the manuscript, it was gone. Instead, the mayor found the note and read it to the townspeople. From that day on, the people thought Cameron was a liar.
If you don't give me 20% of the profits, I'll start telling people about your cave. With a little effort, these idiots will believe in the curse.
with my friends. I know you hid them. Go to the mine. The other kids are there.
Wolf was tired of the teacher meddling in his business. He decided to get rid of her. Wolf wanted to give her a gem in exchange for her leaving the town. Cameron went to the mine alone, but four of her students secretly followed her. They hid and listened to the conversation.
You need to leave town. You're getting in my way.
Your mines are killing people. They're dying because of your greed. The legends are true.
Don't be ridiculous. They're dying because they're useless. Take the gems and leave.
Thank you.
descendants will pay for the sins of their ancestors at midnight.
Thank you.
Your selfishness has driven you mad. I'm not taking anything from you. Nothing can keep me from trying to stop you.
Fine. You've given me no choice. Now!
Oh, what are you doing here?
We know how awful he is. We just wanted to help.
Cameron and her students were buried alive. Wolf told the townspeople that Cameron had gone mad and kidnapped the children. Soon, there were rumors of strange things happening at the cave. The people were scared and started leaving the town. Wolf and the mayor died under strange circumstances. The spirit of revenge haunted the town. Innocent children would be the ones to pay for what had happened.
soon I'll have my revenge! You're still alive? It doesn't matter. You can't save them. What are you staring at? You think you can help?
No!
My students and I are finally free. Thanks for saving my soul from the spirit of revenge.
Ah! Miss Cameron, you're back!
Goodbye.
Aunt Brenda, I'm so glad you're here. I just want to go home.
I'm just glad you found the kids. Something was keeping us from getting into the town.
Oh, thanks, officer. I ran into an old acquaintance, the spirit of revenge. I don't think you should put that part in your report, though. Just get the kids home.
Of course we'll take the kids to their parents right now. I called in another chopper. This one's full, but yours is on the way.
I'm gonna rest here for a while.